where equality is just another euphemism for mediocrity, where participation is more highly valued than achievement, where just enough to get by is the new standard. In a world where equality is just another euphemism for mediocrity, where participation is more highly valued than achievement, where just enough to get by is the new standard of excellence, there is a small minority of people who fight back against such apathy, who struggle daily to reach new heights. These brave few are the hope for the future, the bright shining light for the next generation. They are the ones who will lead us to the places we have never dreamed of, to the undiscovered country, to reach goals only a few can even begin to imagine. Unfortunately, none of those people could be here tonight, so kick back and relax. Prepare yourself for several hours of fun, friendship, fascinating conversation, and fabulous music. All those F's, that's an alliteration and kind of a radio trick. Speaking of radio, you're listening to the most popular radio station in the history of broadcast radio, at least among stations that originate from Chris's living room. It's Curious Times. Your host is a curious listener. Here she is, Chris.
All right. Hey, everybody. Yes. How do I make it stop? Stop. Welcome to Curious Times. It is Monday, August 29th. Three balls up on the Galileo thingy-majiggy. Very little bit chilly. It's getting there. I looked out and saw some leaves turning yesterday, so you know. Anyway, we have Lisa back today with the sort of part two of the Akashic Record deal. And so today we're going to redo that meditation. Lisa's going to do some Akashic Record readings for you guys if you're interested. So tomorrow, Nick Fox had to swap out. So I don't have anything booked, but I might do EVPs or whatever. NAMA Awards, I'm going to be looking at all of the Donald Black Fox Spirit Wind Records nominees and then helping you guys go vote. Amy Kavanaugh is here Friday. Mark your calendars. Jenny Satori's rocking the runes over here. And she's fun, and she's also very good at doing the room readings. Kimber's hopefully going to be here Saturday. Sunday, Hillary Black. And a week from tonight, Nick Fox will be here, rescheduled and relocated. So that's what's coming up for the next week at Curious Times. And so Lisa's here. This is a little bit of old contact information, but we'll get all the new stuff. Plus, it's on the show description itself. And you can get a hold of Lisa at her website at www.skysilverhawk.com. And on Facebook, Sky's Sacred Sanctuary. And please stand by and I'll fire that into the... Oh, okay. Okay, never mind. I'll just do my part and I'll be just fine. And so... here comes Lisa. Hey, Lisa, how's it going?
Hi, sorry. I was trying to save you time.
You're very user-friendly. I'm just not used to, to the guests actually doing anything other than speaking on the show. Oh. You know what I mean? It's great. That's great. I prefer it because, you know, I'm all like, you want me to wipe your bum too? No, I'm just teasing. So, seriously, that's great. And now that Heath is probably in there and he'll probably like post it a couple of times too. Now, am I too loud? I might be too loud.
No.
Okay.
No, you're good.
It's so stupid because I get Skype giving me warning, high sound coming from, it's like, you're high. Never mind. Go away. Don't tell me. And tell me no sound or huge background sound. And then when no one can hear me, like there's no problem, you know what I mean? But anyway, so we had you on a week ago and did the sort of discussed the Akashic Records, tried and failed to do this meditation. And you know what I found out today, Lisa, is that because I was looking for that file so that I could see if I could enhance it further and, you know, if I could redo it here tonight. And since I'm on voice meter, it allows me to, you know, I can jack the sound up even more than on the editing software. And so anyways, I was like trying to find, where did I file that thing? You know what I mean? I found one I did for you, an Akashic Record meditation that I edited for you, like put the music to and everything. Guess what? I picked the same damn music last time. I picked the same music. Out of all the, I have a whole bunch of different background music. You know what I mean? I picked the same music last time. It's a different meditation. They're both for Akashic Records, but that last one was for Akashic Records too, which I did, couldn't remember. You know what I mean? Too many years have gone by. And so it was funny though, because when I hit play, I'm all like, how come that's dated like 2012 or whatever? And that's the music that I'm like, oh my God, how could that even be possible?
It's a perfect song.
Pick the perfect song. Pick the perfect song. Yeah. So anyway, how's things? What's going on?
Things are good. Sammy's been under the weather. So my last few days have been working on him. He had to have his rabies vaccine on Saturday. And, you know, as we all know, vaccines just suck, period. And it's funny to think vaccines are to protect them. No. And so he had a reaction. So even though, you know, I had him on homeopathic meds beforehand. I did healing beforehand. I've been doing healing for 3 days. So today, this afternoon, he finally started feeling better.
Well, that's good.
So we thank God it's only once every 3 years because we don't like this.
No kidding. Well, I don't react very well to needles either, but it has nothing to do with allergic reaction. It's just a psychological reaction. In fact, I just don't. I dodge them. I will do just about anything to avoid a needle. You know.
And, yeah, me too.
Yeah, it's
because they're usually unnecessary.
Well, and you know what? I think that the universe has helped me with this because you know, there's just times when, like, I remember a time when my knee was so injured. You know, from falling on it, and it had. I used to say, like, it has the whole freaking ocean because all it, you tap it and it looks like waves are going through the knee. You know what I mean? Like, there was so much on the knee. And any other person who even only had half the fluid on that knee, they would have drained it.
Right.
Instead, sitting there in the doctor's office, doctor's already going like, blah, blah. And, like, he's like, well, we'll let it go. And I wasn't, like, starting to go, oh, wait a minute now here, you know, or anything like that, because I really can't speak up to doctors very well. At least I couldn't whenever I used to go. It's been years since I really have gone and dealt with doctors. But, and so to my amazement, he's like, we'll let this go for another week or so. And if it's still this bad, then we'll drain it. Right. And I'm all like, I dodged that. I dodged, like anybody else, the sucker would have had the freaking needle out and suctioning out the, and I somehow I avoided that one and I skated on it. And so I've done really well in my life anyway. That has nothing, well, except for that it could have something to do with Akashic Records. The fact that I was born with a fear of doctors and needles could very well have something to do with a previous life and experience, or it could have to do with a knowing that you should just start really young avoiding doctors, Chris. I wrote that into my life path, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I think it served me fairly well because I have really stayed away from doctors, and a lot of the things that I've struggled with, like with the back and all, like if I've been doing the doctor thing, my guts would be so wrecked and my liver would be so wrecked from all the anti-inflammatories and painkillers and everything that they would put you on, that, you know, I would have a whole host of other problems, you know, to deal with in addition to that. So, but so anyway, why don't we refresh everybody about the Akashic Records, about what, how they can be used, you know, to, if we can achieve, master the ability on our own, especially to visit our own Akashic Records, how that can be helpful to us.
Okay. So doing it yourself, so there's a difference between wanting to go to a reader and wanting to do it yourself. Doing it yourself, you should always go with one question, one specific thing you want to know. And what your Akashic Records can do is they can help you better understand relationships. They can better help you better understand contracts, you know, agreements you made with other souls. And, you know, things are always changing, but in some instances we have specific things that we've come to do with or for each other. And what happens a lot of times is we don't realize we're done, or they don't, another person doesn't realize they're done, because we see them as mother, father, sister, brother. You know, we feel like we have to be connected to them, or they've been mine for 30 years, so I have to be connected to them. And you don't, you know, it's what I'm here to accomplish together or help other with together. And when is that over? Now, sometimes you get stuck in that. We know we're still supposed to be here for somebody, but we don't know what for. So you can find out that. You know, your Akashic Records is your blue. What?
You're breaking up. So I'm thinking, I wonder if I should try scooting in on my Skype. I think we did that last time, eh?
Okay.
Did we? Because you're kind of breaking out. I don't know if you're on a wireless connection, or you got maybe a virus scanner running in the back, or something else going on your computer. Because you're cutting that in and out, you know what I mean?
Did I cut out last week? I'm the same as last week.
Okay. I can't remember if I had you on my call last week or not, you know what I mean?
Okay.
But maybe it's just for me. Is it just breaking up for me, you guys, or is it breaking up for you also? Because it's, I don't want to let you talk for, and then to have them all go off. I only got, So, okay, well, you guys let me know if it becomes unmanageable, and I'll bring her in on my call and see if that helps. But if it's only...
Is it because I talk too fast?
I don't think so. No, because Dorothy talks faster than anybody in the whole wide world.
Because I have noticed if I talk too fast, sometimes I cut out.
Okay. Well, talk very slowly.
Slowly. No, it's okay. Yeah. So we'll talk slow. Okay. Anyway, I get excited, so I talk fast. But what you want, the reason you want to address your Akashic Records is to find that information that helps your conscious self here. Because we put stuff in our conscious self that we don't need. So once you better understand a relationship, better understand why you came to do a certain thing, better understand if you've accomplished something and you're just holding on, or somebody else is just holding on, then you can let go. And so to do it yourself, that's why I said you just went with one question. Because it's very hard on a conscious level to go in and ask multiple questions and come back with and remember all the information. So when you have a reading, that's why Akashic Records readings are recorded, because I'm not going to remember either. But you're having someone else go, having someone else verbally tell you what's going on, what information you need for many areas of your life. A reading encompasses several things. Because a lot of times, you know, a relationship has to work, or career has to do with where I'm living. You know, that's part of agreement to certain places they'd be living. You know, certain environments you will be living in, certain countries you will be living in.
So we're breaking up pretty bad still.
Are we?
You know what you can try, Lisa? Because in a way it's an experiment for me as well. You're looking at the chat room right now?
Yes.
see the chat room. So do you see along the very bottom of it where it says like the trademark for IntuiTalks and then all rights reserved, sign up, get your own show, report abuse. And they're like little
Skype
links
in.
That. Yes. Click yeah. Now, first of all, what you have to, as long as you know how to bring your dial pad up on a Skype call, which would just be on your Skype menu, you would click on the call option, and then it's a drop-down menu, and it says show dial pad. So you would click on that Skype button, and then it's going to ask you for the access code, and that's why you'll need your dial pad. And the access code, shoot, I thought I recorded it. I copied it. The access code is 73187. Oh, for crying out loud. Okay, thank you, Heath. 73187.
Okay, I can do it. It's telling me my laptop doesn't support it.
You don't have Skype?
I do have Skype.
Huh.
Okay, but it's not letting me, like, connect from here. Like, on Skype and call you.
Isn't that funny? Okay, well, I'll just pull you in on mine. So click on the little headset thing in the upper left to cancel your sound here, and I'll scoot you in on my Skype call.
Do what again?
Okay, so in the upper left hand of the window, there's a little picture of a headset.
Yes.
Click on that, and that'll cancel your sound. Okay, I'm one ringy dingy. Oh, she has to log into Skype. Log into Skype. Okay. Da 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 da. You have to log into Skype, Lisa. It would have told, yeah. Lisa, are you reading chat? You need to log onto Skype. Or she's on a different account. Log on to Skype. Doing it. Very good. And I should see when she does. Says offline. Tell me when, Lisa. Oh, doing it, taking a minute. Okay, she has to get her password. I should see the minute she's. Oh, there she is. Kate, beautiful. All right, there you go. Oh, for crying out loud, now it's, you know. Okay, conversation. Add people. Lisa, add to call. I should have stopped the record button. Great feature of IntuiTalks is you can stop and that you didn't have here. Answer. It should be ringing, Lisa. Should be ringing. You should be having an incoming call to answer. Something is not working. Okay. I don't know what to do now. Guess we may have to put up with the breaking up. She is online. Okay, you know what I'm... Okay, hang on. That just failed. Here, I'm going to try her again. Hang on. No. Okay, well, I guess we will have to go with the choppy sound. And so go ahead and quick. Oh, you know what? Try one more time now that you are logged in to hit that Skype button. Exciting, riveting radio at Curious Times. She saw my message. Okay. Strange. What? Anyway, it doesn't matter. Okay. Click the headset again then and reactivate your mic. You're the only person I have never not been able. You can't. No, that's okay. Well, I'll go with the choppy sound. Like, you know what I mean, you guys? I don't know. Go with the choppy sound. Okay, there we go. Maybe it's sorted out now anyway. Hi, Lisa.
Hi.
Okay. Well, so, yeah, you're the only person ever that I haven't been able to...
What
browser, what computer are you... Like, I mean, what operating system are you using?
Oh, I'm on my Google Chrome. I'm on my Chromebook.
Yeah, it should be.
It should.
It's illogical, and really.
And I shut everything else down so that was the only thing running.
Do you have a paid Skype account?
I seem to recall. Yeah, I have. No, I don't have a paid account.
Oh, okay.
Not anymore. I just have a freebie.
Okay. But otherwise, you could. Dial into the show number from Skype and work it that way. Just for the heck of it, because now I'm perplexed. As just go on Skype and just click to call me. Just click to call me and okay. I'll see if a call actually comes through.
Calling.
Okay. Yeah, I'm getting it. Add. Okay, now I'm going to add you to my group call. Oh.
That's funny.
Add to group call. Answering this call will put you on hold, or add to group call. I'm clicking and it will add you to the group call. So I hung up on that. Now try one last thing. One last thing, just because, like, I'm totally perplexed. And
wait a minute, I have to hang up. I got your recording.
Okay.
You have a British accent.
I put this Canadian accent on as a fake, a complete fake. I'm actually. And in fact, I am the same lady. And at my side job is I am who's that chick on the iPhones or whatever that they ask the questions to, the robotic chick.
I can't remember her name. Yeah.
Okay, now trying to do is find the address. So let me just I had it. Can somebody tell what was the name of that IntuiTalks? Okay, here, I know how to find it. IntuiTalks. Now, so, hang on. What I'm going to do here is I am going to, I'm just going to, la. Okay, now I'm going to close that. Lisa. Lisa. What I'm going to do is drag and drop the IntuiTalks. Okay, so now there's the contact for the IntuiTalks. That's the IntuiTalks. Like, if you were to click the Skype button, that's the contact that you're actually calling. Did you see in the Skype that I sent you a contact? If you add that to your contacts and then try to just Skype to Skype call it from within your Skype and see what happens.
Okay, give me a sec.
Okay. Because I shut it off. I'm all about solving problems, you know what I mean? I have a problem that needs solving and it must be solved now. I'm stubborn, right?
Yes, you are.
Not my fault. It was built into my Akashic Record.
Add to contacts.
You see the option to just add it to your contacts, yeah?
Yes, I just did.
Okay. Now go to that contact in your left panel. Just like when you called me, you just clicked on my name and you clicked call, right? Try that.
Yes.
And then you'll have to punch in that 7 if it works.
Oh, geez.
We'll get you the number if it works. That's the least of our problems.
Okay.
Did it work? Is it working?
I'm not hearing anything. It says I'm connected, but it's blank. You know? Wait a minute.
So, you know what I'm going to do? I'm going to... Oh, you know why? Because you're on... Wait a minute. Are you on my... How are you here? Can I hear you? Speak, Lisa. Okay, now I lost your sound. Here, I'm going to just play the meditation and try and sort this out with Lisa, you guys. So get yourselves comfortable. And it's like 8 minutes, okay? And here we go.
Get in a comfortable position, either lying down or sitting up without slouching, and close your eyes. Tune into your breathing your breath right down into your belly. Breathe in. And out. Breathe in. And out. Call the light of the divine to yourself now, flooding your body and your aura in a column of brilliant white light, aligning you with all that is above and all that is below. You feel the ground under your feet and realize that you are standing on sacred ground. The mist around you begins to clear as you take in the landscape in front of you. Off to the left, you see a door with a cave surrounding it. Beautifully carved door with foliage hanging around the outside walls of the cave. Before you venture towards the door, your gatekeeper arrives. This guide is here to protect you and take you on your journey to the Great Hall, where you can view your Akashic Records. You take a moment to greet each other, for it has been a long time since you have been connected. Your gatekeeper walks you over to the door and summons you to open it. Once you look inside, you realize you have opened the door to an elevator. You both step in, and the gatekeeper presses the button on the panel. Once pressed, it turns gold, and you feel the movement of the elevator going up. After what seems like a very long time, the elevator stops and the door opens. You step out and see a hall of large ancient pillars at the entrance in front of you. Walking through the pillars, you see rows of shelves with thousands of small cubes, each holding a precious scroll. You take a moment to perceive your surroundings with all your senses. At the end of the room, you see another threshold. You cross the threshold into a smaller and more private room. You are greeted by another guide, your wisdom keeper, standing at a podium. He acknowledges you and your gatekeeper. Your gatekeeper steps back and you step forward. Your wisdom keeper asks you why you have come. You explain your reasons, your needs to view a particular record or understand a particular lesson. Then you focus through your heart chakra to that of your wisdom keepers, allowing a knowing to take over between the two of you. Your wisdom keeper walks over to the bookcase and pulls out a scroll. The scroll has the record of the knowledge and events of your past and future lives. Standing next to your wisdom keeper, he turns the pages of the scroll until you see a date or name that resonates with your question. Viewing the page, you are taken through the event of your memories, showing you how this lesson came to be, why you need to learn it now, and how you have missed the lesson in the past. Finally, your wisdom keeper speaks, telling you what you can do in this lifetime to address the issue so that you can break the cycle. What the wisdom keeper has given you has been placed in your heart chakra to return with you when your journey is over. Now is the time to ask your wisdom keeper for advice on dealing with your situation and how best to change it, end it, or adjust it. For in this third dimension you live in, you have the free will to choose. You may either place the lesson forward into another lifetime, choose to deal with it now, or realize it has been stuck due to another's emotional imbalances towards you. Your wisdom keeper shows you what will happen in each particular scenario in order to be certain you are not creating more cycles or lessons upon yourself or others unnecessarily. When you are finished, the wisdom keeper returns the scroll to the shelf. Suddenly, your gatekeeper materializes next to you, and you both bid a thank you and a farewell to the wisdom keeper. You turn and walk back through the doorway into the main hall where you see, on the other side, the door to the elevator. The elevator door opens. You step in. And the gatekeeper pushes the button again, this time turning it a bright shade of green. The doors close and you feel the movement of the elevator descending. Once the elevator stops moving, the doors open and you are back on the earthly ground where your gatekeeper guides you to a small lake. Here you sit together discussing your experience. You have decided what to do or not to do with your gatekeeper's assistance. Suddenly, a mist takes over the lake, and as you turn back to the gatekeeper, he is no longer visible. You are able to feel him next to you, but no longer see him, as you are lifted from the land and placed back into your third dimensional world. Feeling the ground under your body, touching every nerve ending and muscle, hearing movements outside, you stretch your arms out and above your head as you return to the present moment. When you are ready, open your eyes. Thank you.
Sweet. So I'm going to stop that there, you guys. And now, so we didn't solve the problem, but we got to move on. So we're going to go grab Lisa here. Hi, Lisa.
Hi.
Now, you say you have somebody in the, I don't get, like, I just get, like, an anonymous person or a cell phone here or a cell phone there. So I cannot see a Florida caller unless they're the wireless caller. So whoever your, what's the lady's name that you said you had someone calling in?
Jenny.
So, Jenny, if you're on the telephone right now, can you just press your one button one time? Press the number one once on your phone and say hello. Jenny from Florida.
Okay, hello?
Yeah,
hello.
Hello.
Hello. How's
hello.
It going? What's going on? So you called to say you love us, or?
Absolutely. I love you. And I've known Lisa a long time now, and I love her, and this is
oh.
fantastic.
Well, it's not my our best
outing. Yeah.
But anyway, so Lisa, what was you were going to get?
Jenny has had an Akashic Records reading with me. It's been a while, but
yeah.
I wanted her to give the people listening some feedback as to what she experienced. She doesn't have to like share all her personal stuff, but you know, to give a general idea of what it was like for her, how it helped her, if it didn't help her, you know, all of that.
Okay. You're on. You're on, Jenny.
Okay. And even just listening to what you guys were saying before, when you were describing the purpose of one, it even made me have more questions now, like, you know, how can it help us? So it was really interesting. But anyway, back in 2012, I had my reading with Lisa, and it was at a time when I had become ill, and I did not realize the extent of the illness. And I just thought, I'll get better any day now. I just got to get through this, and it didn't. And I kept sinking further and further down. And so I sought out Lisa's help saying, and like she said, picking that one question, kind of being specific. So I said, what is the purpose of this illness and how can I move past it? And so I won't go into detail about it, but basically it gave me hope. It gave me that glimpse into why and what I could do with it, what I would be able to help others with, because of the experience, and it gave me hope and it gave me a sense of purpose even. So during the next year plus that it took me to heal my body, I will tell you, I kept going back to that reading because it's honestly what kept me going even on those hard days when I didn't want to get out of bed or I broke down crying because I was tired of being in pain. Having that reading gave me a sense of purpose. This is why I have this. This is why I'm here. Or, you know, whatever it happens to be in any person's particular situation. For me, it gave me something to hang on to. And it has. There are other things that were brought up in the reading as well with relationships, who I was married to at the time, the number of children that I have, a lot of things. And things in my life have changed now, which also brought up another question. It's like, I don't know how to even, I would love to ask Lisa at another point, how does that work when your life changes so dramatically after an illness, for instance, or after another traumatic event, whatever it may be? Does your blueprint still stay the same? Because isn't that kind of what an Akashic Record reading is, or the Akashic Record is, the blueprint for this life?
Mm-hmm. But what happens is you were stuck. You were very stuck for a long time. So what happened was you got back on your path. And just because some of the people changed doesn't mean your path changed.
Very true. Yes.
Like
I remember you.
What's the nearest town to you? What's the nearest? You know what I mean? Like, pick a nearest town to you. And so
Orlando.
How long does it take you to get to Orlando?
Well, 30 minutes.
Okay. So now if you went a different way or you decided to go faster or slower, it would take you less or more time to get there. You're still going to get there. That is your plan. That is your destination. And so so that's how I look at that, is that like it's there as a major event in your life. And the free will part of it comes in as to how quickly or slowly do we get through that part and get it accomplished. You know what I mean? And so if I wanted to go to Calgary, it takes me 3 hours. But if I go via Winnipeg, it take me 3 weeks. You know what I mean?
Right.
So sometimes when we get stuck, like we're going via Winnipeg. It's like it reminds me of this commercial. Like this guy gets on an airplane and he thinks he's going to fly, and then the plane is lifting off and they're all like, you know, it's like, you know, the travel time to Winnipeg is like, he goes like, going to Winnipeg. So anyway. So you found it helpful, if nothing else, like, because in your reading, were you able to discover that you were going to recover from this thing and how to, or just that you were going to recover from it, or what was it that gave you the hope?
What, and it wasn't like, you will heal from this, you will do that. It was basically saying, okay, I guess I'll share a little bit of it. I remember Lisa specifically saying, or whoever is actually speaking as you're reading the book, I don't know, but she was saying, I came here to be ill. But through, within my remission, I will help others heal. That's the gist of it.
Yeah.
You know, there's lots of details around that, but that was the gist of it. And so I remember asking her, my remission, does that mean it's going to come back? You know, like, is this a long-term remission? Is this temporary remission? And she says, I don't know. She's like, I'm just reading this word for word.
I'm on page 89, and we're only at page 4. You'll have to call back.
Right. It was so interesting because it just gave me, like I said, it almost gets you right back on track. I even remember at the end of the reading, and is it the gatekeeper? All of a sudden you said, he closed the book. That he says, that's all you need to know. And it was over. But it was just that glimpse that all of a sudden went bloop and almost got me unstuck right then and there. And even though I still had the illness to go through, I was only at the beginning of it. I was still going, what is this? It literally carried me through, and I knew that it was for a purpose. I knew it wouldn't break me. Do you know what I mean? I knew there was sunshine on the other side. And for somebody like me, it was exactly what I needed.
Right. Yeah. Well, that's good. I'm glad that you could take some time out of your day to call and let us know about your experience with that. I always say, like, this the stuff I want to know, they don't want me to know. It pisses me off. You know what I mean? All the rest of it, I know. Like, I want to know this other stuff, and it's always like, no, you know. Like, even when I got this painting from Renee Richards, she says, usually when she sends these paintings out to people, that she gives them, you know, like names and stuff like this, that all, it's a spiritual painting. And it's all, and she's all, I go, Renee, like, was there, like, I'm looking on the back, I'm looking for, you know, where's the thing that gives all the names? And so I write to her and she's all, I was told not to tell you because you can find it. What? Everybody in the world gets the freaking names, but I can find them myself, right? Like, oh my God, you know? And so that's in my Akashic Records too, you know what I mean? It's like, oh, you know that you can find the answer yourself. Oh my God, you gotta be kidding me. So anyway, I think because, you know, I would take the easy way out or something in every instance, you know what I mean? And I guess I must have decided no easy way out in this lifetime. So I probably was the author of that, my own damn self, you know. But anyway, I always laugh, though. It's always that way for me, everything. It's funny. So anyway, okay. So thank you very, very much for calling in, Jenny. Appreciate that.
Absolutely.
Thank you.
You take good care. And so now the people are starting to pile in. So I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, maybe about 6 or so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, about 6 or so. So we should probably get going pretty quick, and we'll have to, you know, can't go much more than about 10 minutes max on any one person, if you know what I mean.
Okay.
So I don't know if you were here during the incarnation of the crickets, but
oh yes, I remember the crickets. Yeah, I remember them.
Time to wind up. I will try not to invoke the crickets.
So then let's lay some ground rules for people who are calling in. One question. And be specific, because when I go into access your records, and I'm going to say a prayer before you start this internally that opens the records of everyone I need. And then when I'm done, I'm going to do the same thing and I'll close them. So I'm not doing it for every person.
Okay. And the other thing is we can assume, I hope you'll go along with this too. We can assume that by, anybody who's calling in for a reading, that they're granting you, by calling, they're
right.
granting you access.
They're granting access.
You know what I mean? So we can forego those formalities as well. If you're calling in, you're granting, you're asking Lisa to access your records for
right.
you, and you're giving all permissions necessary. So set your intent in that way, callers as well. And
let me give you an example of a question, because this is what a lot of people will do in their readings. They'll be like, could you tell me about my relationship with my mother?
Right.
Well, that's a big can of worms. Be specific. You know, if you want to know about a specific relationship with someone, don't give me their name. Give me their relation to you, because we don't want to use their name on the air. In a private session, you would. But not here. And, you know, specifically about that relationship, you know, why do I feel like this toward my mother? Or why does my mother act like this toward me? Be specific as to that thing you want to know so that we can get through everyone.
So if it were me, I would go like, not to mention any names, but why am I having such a problem with not to mention any names, but their initials are Mary Margaret Simmons? Just kidding. I gotcha. Just teasing. and so, okay. So with that said, you guys, I noticed I was taking as careful track of the callers as I could as they were coming in. So I'm going to go to the best of my ability in the order that I saw them coming. And so Linda was in there first. Hi, Linda.
Hello.
Are you calling for just listening, or are you calling for an Akashic Record question?
Yes, for the question.
Hey, go for it.
Yes, my question is, I'd like to know why I am stuck in this health situation that I'm in, you know, and how to move forward.
Okay, specific. What health situation?
Oh, gosh, like one thing go wrong, something else happened, like, where I can't walk that good anymore. Oh gosh, just like I feel like I'm deteriorating, you know, but everything's just going wrong.
Sorry, this isn't specific enough for an Akashic reading. That would be really good for a medical reading, but not for an Akashic reading.
Okay, like something like what I'm in now, but then like, does the reading say something like I'm going to be moving forward, I'm looking to a brighter future? Is that?
I'm sorry, say that again?
So what I wanted to know, like with the health, but also like, am I going to be getting out of that situation?
So I don't know if this will work or not, but now I'm assuming that you have a few different things, symptoms or whatever, challenges health-wise that are restricting your enjoyment of life and or your ability to do certain things, that activities that you perhaps would want to do. Is that correct?
Yes.
Okay, and did all of these things sort of, are they all possibly connected, yes or no?
Oh, gosh. Yeah, it could be.
Okay. So, like, you know, because, you know, when I think about things like that they tag as, like, your chronic fatigue or your fibromyalgia, like, it involves a whole bunch of problems, you know what I mean? And that's usually the challenge of why it's hard to diagnose. And so a person, as the thing progresses, autoimmune, whatever it is that's happening, as it progresses, it starts to incorporate more and more areas or symptoms or challenges and limitations. And so can you not just say, like, could she just say that, when did this start? When did your health fall into a struggle for you, Linda?
Oh, gosh. Let's see. Back in 79 when I broke my back.
Yeah.
And then little by little, it's been happening. The worst had just started.
Okay.
Okay, so would this be your question? Am I supposed to learn something from this? You know, why do I have this? What am I supposed to gain from it?
Yes.
Okay.
The purpose of three received in 1979 or thereabouts.
Okay, so I'm going to go quiet for a minute, and then I'll just, my eyes will be closed, but I'll be talking. And I'm sorry, your first name one more time?
Linda.
Thank you, Linda. Okay, so the first thing I'm seeing is I'm seeing an accident. So is that what happened in the 70s? You had an accident?
Yes, I did.
Okay. Because I'm seeing this accident that you never recovered from. Like, yeah. So, all right, I want to back out so that I can talk. It wasn't, you didn't have the accident, like, it wasn't, like, part of your life purpose to have this accident. You had an accident, and what they showed me was you just held on to whatever the pain was, whatever the issues were that led up to it. Now, when we have a major accident in our lives, I can tell you from experience, there's shit going on in our lives.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what they're showing me is, like, you haven't learned whatever you before that accident, and you've just held on to all of this, and it's multiplied. So now you've got other things going on, and you've got other issues, and it's like layers of paint on the wall. You've just kept adding to the same thing. And it's like every time your self added was another sign to let go. But what happens is we're human and we just attach. So, yeah. So what your gatekeeper says is you need to go back to that time. And what I'm seeing is like 1 to 3 months before your accident, whatever was going on in your life, make sure you forgave people in your life, that you forgave yourself. And I don't mean like, oh, I don't worry about that anymore. I let go of it. No. Forgiveness. Serious forgiveness of the other people and yourself. Because it takes two to tango. We put ourselves in those situations. And that's all they're showing me. It's like that. So what that is that's your first step. Your first step is to go back and do that.
Okay, so like the person I was in the accident with, that's the one I forgive?
You haven't forgiven. Because in some way, shape, or form, you put yourself in that situation. And while, yes, it might be someone else's fault, and I can tell you from experience, someone else's fault for the accident, but not for you being in the accident.
Right.
You placed yourself in that position. Then going back, like almost 3 months before that. Like something happened about 3 months before that, and all of a sudden it's just trickle, trickle, trickle. You were probably getting signs and not realizing you were getting signs. So whatever it was, I always say look at yourself first, because once you can see what you were going through and what you missed, what signs you missed and how you put yourself in that position, it's actually easier to forgive someone else than it is to forgive yourself.
Can I ask you a question?
Go ahead.
Not you, Lisa.
Oh.
Linda?
Yes, you can.
Okay. Back at that time, were you possibly in a relationship or a job that wasn't working, that there was dysfunction, toxicity, or something like that? Yes or no?
No.
So you, all your relationships were fine at that time? Everything was fine?
Yes.
Okay.
See, I'm getting little things. I'm not getting it's something major. I'm getting a lot of little things led up to this. And it's those little things. And it's just a conversion. And I can tell you from my accident, there was a lot of little stuff in my life. Nothing major. But enough to cause me to be off path.
Yeah.
Of my soul path.
Well, so, and that's where I was going with it, was like, you're getting like that there's a place you are, or a person you're with, or someone that's in your life who isn't supposed to be, like that it's time to move on from. And you were getting, you know, little hints and nudges along the way that were being ignored. And then finally, the same thing happened to me, you know what I mean, with my accident.
Yes.
And it was that I was supposed to have left my job before I left my job. And what happened is the universe helped me leave my job. It would have been a lot better for me moving forward if I would have left willingly and on my own. You know what I mean? And so, you know, it's a long time ago and everything like this. And so start with forgiving yourself. Start with forgiving the person that had the collision with you. But start to wonder and maybe even meditate on the question of, like, just sit quietly pondering on the question of, you know, why did that accident happen? You know what I mean? And see if something jumps into your mind about it. But, you know, that's kind of the advice that Lisa's giving you, is that at the very least, forgive yourself and forgive the person that hit you. But there's still, and I agree with her, that there's something that happened leading up to it.
Yeah.
That brought all of those conditions into being. So it's a long time ago to try and remember a blow by blow of our lives. You know.
Yeah,
what I mean?
But usually when we have a trauma like that, if you can just sit in meditation, you can just sit quiet with your eyes closed and ask your guides to take you back. You know, it may take a couple of days of a couple of attempts. But you'll go back. It's not like you have to remember every part of your life. You have to remember how you got there. Like, what is that root? You know, it's like with the medical, it's like, what's the root cause? It's the same with traumas. Where was that first sign? So that would be a really good thing, to sit in meditation and say, what was that first sign? Because if you can see that first sign, you probably get it. You'll probably understand what you were supposed to be learning at that time.
Okay. Makes sense.
Sometimes it could be as simple as you have somebody so fiercely independent, right, that they don't need anybody else, so that they come into a situation where they need other people now to help them, you know, if they're sick or if they're injured or something, then now you need to have other people helping you. And so what if it was something like that, that, you know, it was a way to teach you to instead of being the caregiver all the time, receive the care, but then you were okay to, you know, not have that go on and on and on. And so I'm just throwing that out as an example or a possibility.
That sounds right. I mean, that's how I've been. I'm always the one taking care now. Or how I'm at now, it's my time. Exactly,
right.
You hit
right.
It.
So now when you can receive the help and know how to ask for help when you need it, right, that could just be the lesson itself. And now you can go, okay, when I need help, I will ask for it. but I'd rather, you know, be able to do more and more on my own, right? That's a good affirmation to sort of start with as well, in my opinion, you know? And
yes.
So, but I got to move on because I'm...
I'm going to play crickets for you soon.
I know, I know. But I think that we got you on the track. On the track.
Yes,
to bring that out.
Yes, we did. Thank you so much.
Good
Thank
luck.
You.
Okay. All right.
Thank
Bye-bye. You. And talk to you later. Okay, so there we go. Okay, let's go get Eric. Where's Eric? There he is. Hi, Eric. Wait. Hi, Eric. Eric, going once, going twice. Kate, we'll come back to Eric. Anonymous, you'll hear a beep in your ear. Who's this? Hello?
Hello, hello.
Hello? Hey, I'm going to click on your thing, and you'll hear another beep. Now you're going to hear another beep. Who's this? Okay, I'm moving on. All right. Well, we have more time than I thought we had.
Okay. So, do you know where Jenny is? Because she would like to ask a question. She just messaged me.
Okay, I'm gonna. She wants to have a reading also.
She wants to have a reading also. Yes.
Well, I'll get to her. I'll get to her. So okay. I'm gonna hit Sherry here. Sherry.
Oh, hey, Chris. Hi,
How's
Lisa.
It going?
Good.
Hi.
Hi. Well, this is like opening Pandora's box. It's like, it's where do you start? You could go back and back and back because it's like peeling the onion.
Right.
So I guess I'm going to start with, I want to work on my spiritual path, but I keep putting up these blocks and I'll go a certain point and then I'll stop and it affects everything else in my life. So it's like, why?
Why are you hitting roadblocks?
Right. Why am I? Right.
Okay.
What's back there that's causing that I can't seem to get past these and keep putting them up?
Okay. Give me just one second. Oh, okay. So, well, your gatekeeper did not pull this, see, I see scrolls. Some people see books, I see scrolls. And the scroll he pulled was from, I don't know how many lifetimes ago. I'm feeling like I'm in the 1600s.
Okay.
But from the energy. And I'm countryside. I'm going to say Ireland, England. Maybe Sweden, but, you know, that kind of countryside.
Mm-hmm.
Sorry, I'm taking in so that I can speak. It's okay. Ooh. Okay, so you had a lifetime where you lived in some kind of countryside. Quiet, you know, kind of... How do I explain this? Like, away from Rome, you know, because everything coming out of Rome was to change the world, you know, with Christianity or with Catholicism mm-hmm. and all of that. And you, it's literally like what I'm seeing is like maybe London was full of all of these changes, but you were like in a Scotland countryside and you were like oblivious to all that and you didn't grow up with that and you were very much of the earth and you were very much living your own, you, your family, friends, living your own way. And your town was taken over. Mm. And those who didn't adjust were killed.
Oh, wow.
You were killed. Okay, that was nausea. So what happened is something in your life, I'm seeing like something probably in your childhood, because that's usually where we have them. Somebody said something, somebody put a seed in your head that doing something different than the norm, you know, what other people were doing, was not right. Hmm. And so what your gatekeeper is showing me is like, you try to, it's like you take all these roads. Okay, well, I'll try and learn this. Ugh, I hit a barricade. Well, maybe if I go over here and learn this, well, another barricade. And it's all, and they're just showing me it's a seed stuck. It's a subconscious seed that's making you stuck. And so the first thing I heard from your gatekeeper was define what you really want. Because you're going here and you're getting stuck, and then you're going over here and then you're getting stuck, and then you're trying something else and get stuck. It's like pull back and say, who am I? What am I? What do I want to be? And that is what you learn instead of different things. Because I'm going, oh, these other things really aren't part of your path. They're things you might want to know and understand, but they're not part of who you are or what you're meant to be. And whatever it is you do for a living right now is not what you're supposed to be doing.
Yeah, I know that.
Like, not at all. Like, you.
I'm so far. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. But you're not. You just need to know that. You're not. It feels far because you keep hitting these obstacles. So, kind of redefined yourself in the sense of, we all really know who we are and why we're here if we get quiet enough and if we go inside enough. It's that we're scared.
Right.
And the interesting thing is we're scared to be great. And we shouldn't be. We should be scared to be normal. You know, what the world considers normal. Because
right.
I'm not in that normal group. I never have been. I never have been. I've always been, oh my God, you know, I was a kid that everybody came to for answers, you know, and I was a really smart kid in school because I just channeled stuff. I never studied for a test and I always aced it because I just channeled it. I know, pissed my brothers off. Oh, you would. But because that wasn't important to me. I knew I had to get somewhere. But, you know, I was not the normal child. And there was some fear. You know, I grew up in the 60s in the South, in segregation, in Ku Klux Klan. And if you weren't part of what we believe in, you're the devil.
Right.
And I know my parents had fear that there was going to be a stake burning out in their front yard one day. Even though we were Catholic, didn't matter. I still had this voodoo thing going on, you know. But there's always that, and I still have that. I still have that tiny, tiny seed of fear. But it gets smaller and smaller. The more you define what you really want to do. People always ask me, what did I come here for? Well, what do you want to be here for? Because that's part of it. That's part of the free will. You know, you may have come here to be a healer, but how you heal is up to you. Some people choose Reiki. Some people choose hands-on. Some people choose massage therapy and do, you know, hands-on healing. Some choose to heal pets. So long as you're on that path, you have personal choice. So don't get stuck in kind of like, who am I supposed to be? It's who do you think you are?
Okay.
And personally, meditation is like the best place to find things. I have to say this. I don't know why I have to say this. So you must need this.
Okay.
There is a meditation on my website. I have free meditations on the skysilverhawk.com website.
Right.
And there is one that says to meet your tribe. We have two tribes. We in how shamanism works. We have two tribes. We have our other world tribe, which is kind of like my grandmother Winnie, you know, and all these people who work with me to help me through my life. And then there's the upper world tribe. And these are, this is like where you would go if you wanted to change your contract, or where you would want to go if, you know, you wanted to change something in your life, just something, or get incredible spiritual knowledge. That's where I go when I'm completely lost, because at that point I'm not listening to my other world guides.
Right.
I'm too stuck. So where was I going with this? Oh, so the meditation I have on there is to meet your other world tribe. And when you meet your other world tribe, you meet at this table and you can ask questions. And this is for everybody. You can ask questions. You can find out, you know, why did I come to be a healer? Why, you know, that should be, once you determine who you are and what you're here to be, then you should have your Akashic Records read as to, okay, what do I do with this? And why did I come to be a healer?
Mm.
Like, I always thought I came to be a healer for people. And my healing is strictly for pets. I mean, I do shamanic healing, soul retrieval on humans. But I, you know, it took me 30 years to realize that I was supposed to do it on animals. So I was still on my path. It just took me a while to figure out that, to pinpoint it.
Okay. Cool.
So definitely try that meditation. And when you're at the table, you know, if you know inside what it is you really want to do, I want to be a tarot reader, I want to be a doctor, I want to be a lawyer, I want to be whatever. Just ask for guidance on why did I choose that? And that'll help you see your path a little more clearly.
Okay, cool.
Okay.
Thank you very much.
You're welcome, honey. Good luck.
All right. Thank you.
Okay.
And be a stamp licker. That's disgusting. Okay. just have a bowl of glue, you know what I mean? And you'll.
I don't think that's a job, Christy.
Yeah, especially since, you know, pretty soon stamps will be even, what's the word I'm looking at? We're going to go and we're going to get Jenny, then we're going to go get Christy, then we're going to go get whoever's in ID. Is that Indiana or whoever ID is, Idaho or Indiana? Which is ID? Anyhow. Jenny.
Yes.
Hi, Jenny.
Well, hello again. Okay, so my turn to ask a question?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay, I think I got it. I want to know why I feel stuck again, even though I'm in a fantastic relationship. I have this intense feeling of I'm stuck. Like I went backwards, where, and I can't quite figure it out.
Okay. And so for people who are listening, you know, hers wasn't a very specific like I've been asking. However, I have read Jenny completely before, so it's very easy for me to go back and pull. So I'm hearing it's all about your father.
Okay.
So, and on the scroll, what I saw was literally, I live here, I moved here, I moved over here. Something happened to my father and I went all the way back around to here. And now I'm starting over. And it's it's kind of like, it feels like an emotional roller coaster feeling.
Yes.
And it's that mothering feeling.
Yes.
You're taking, so, it's like you're taking on that mother role again. And it's not for you to take.
Where the mother role is coming in, it's almost like I'm mothering my partner.
Well, then stop it.
All right. So your gatekeeper says yes, but I'm linking back to your father.
Yeah, and you know what? I haven't been able to mentally go see my father. There's something going on there, I guess. I have, you know, he's sick. You know about him. And
yes.
He says, when are you coming to see me? And I can't get myself to go. Something's not happy there.
Okay, so the gatekeeper says you're reflecting off on your husband. That's why you're having the issue with your husband. It's not your husband. It's your father.
That's
go
so
see him. Limit your visit.
Okay. Actually, I was going to go today. It's funny. I said, Dad, coming over today. He says, honey, not today. I'm too tired. We're finally going to go. And he was too tired, so I didn't go.
Because you have to go for a purpose. And I'm hearing you're going for the wrong reason.
Oh, yeah.
Totally yeah. The wrong reason. You're going because you're his daughter. And you want to spend time with him as his daughter. God, these like these big letters in front of me. As his daughter, not his mother, not his nursemaid, not anything.
I see. I'm going, I don't know if I know how to do that.
I know. And if you have to, take someone with you.
Okay.
Take a child.
Well, I kind of have a child.
No, I'm seeing one of the girls. No, I'm seeing one of the girls.
Okay, okay. Well, that's interesting. I didn't expect you to say that at all.
Yeah, Jenny has a baby boy, but she also has some girls.
Just a few.
Yeah. Take one of the girls.
Okay. That's interesting. I did not know that.
You take all of them. That will help limit your time there.
All of them, drop them off and get the hell out of
no. No, but you need to, they're saying you need to go. Because this squirrely roundabout trip that, you know, your soul is making, it needs to be broken. It's like, it just needs to be disintegrated. And it won't until you go see him. And he is fine, you know. He just needs to recover.
Yeah. I kind of got to where he was fine. I feel like he's fine without me. I don't even know what role I fill for him anymore. I don't know. I don't understand it.
You're his daughter. There is no role. You're his daughter. Listen to the voice of experience.
Yes,
who,
yes.
Who had
true.
To be there for her father. Right.
Right.
That was my role. And I knew it was my role. And I checked to make sure it was my role before I took it on. This is not your role. Your role with him is to be his daughter. He has a husband. He has a husband?
No, he has a partner, yeah. Yeah, he does.
Okay, well, same thing. He has
same part, yeah.
It's his responsibility.
And that's how I feel. I was able to easily step away from that with no guilt and say, okay, I can't fulfill that. This person can. I'm okay.
And it's just because of the type of person you are. You want to do that. He's your father. You want to, but it's not. And there's the lesson, which is why the universe keeps going, you know, you can have me. I can't be there. I can go. You can't have me. It's like, you got to be on the same wavelength if you're going to have a good relationship. You're just his daughter.
Okay. Okay. I'm understanding better. I keep thinking, what are we doing? We have nothing anymore.
Nothing
in common.
Else in your contract with him just to be his daughter.
Then on the other side of it, and then we'll go is revisit your idea of what is it to care for somebody. In other words, I think that you have a link in your mind that to take care of someone, that is a mother thing. Whereas you can take care of a partner without being their mother. And
right.
So, Lose the idea that mother, you know, nobody wants to have a mother for a wife. You know what I mean? Seriously. And if they do, then they're not really desirable to be with. And
right.
I don't guess that's your case right now. So I think that only revolves around like maybe you're the kind of person that needs to be taking care of people, but you can take care of people or help people or support people without being the mother. You know what I mean?
Well, that's the problem I feel I have with my partner. His mom was taking care of him, and now I feel like I just took that over. But I don't know how to not, because I care about him. I don't know how to not.
But here's an example, okay? It's like that there's stuff that an accountable adult is responsible for, right? Now, here, can I help you do this, or here, I'll cook for you, or whatever. But it's not like, oh, well, now I have to pick up this after you, or I have to do that. I have to make your appointments, or I have to do this for you. I have to, you know, do all of these things, you know? Like, there's things that he's quite capable, probably. If there's anything he's capable of doing on his own, then let him do that on his own. You know what I mean? And if you do it, doing it to help, not to mother, you know? So move from caregiver to spouse slash help. Like, when I do something to help somebody, it's not that I don't think they can do it for them, you know, like it's because I just want to pitch in and help them or make that a little bit easier for them. But the next time I don't feel compelled to, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So I just think you should think about what your connection is with, like, I think in your mind, mothers take care of everything, and that's what you're doing. Mm-hmm. And so you can still help a, you can still be a supportive partner without being that.
Right.
It's a partnership. It's not a relationship. It's a partnership that we have with other people. We have partnerships. We have agreements. And it's what are we meant that, what do we have there? You're not meant to be his mother. He has a mother. She's doing just fine. Let her. Let them have that relationship. You're his partner. So there's equality. Whatever his relationship with his mother isn't an equal thing, or it is in their respect. Yours is different.
Right. Okay.
So it's what is your partnership with him?
Right. And I guess I just thought, oh, I just gotta take over that role. I didn't realize I did it. I didn't even realize I did it. And now I'm going, oh my gosh, I'm exhausted. I'm experiencing ups and downs like depressive or anxious behaviors. I'm taking care of the five
children. Because you're taking on stuff you're not supposed to.
I'm taking on stuff I don't need to be doing.
Right.
This should help you. You would not treat your son like your husband, so don't treat your husband like your son. Okay?
Right.
I like that, yeah.
So if you remind yourself of that, you know, you know the boundaries with your son. You're not going to have a husband, you know, a partner, a relationship like that with your son. So similarly, you both deserve not to have that relationship within the relationship.
Okay.
Hey, Jenny?
Yep.
Okay. Thank you.
Thank you,
Jenny. Thank you so much. Uh-huh.
Good luck.
Bye.
And,
bye.
Okay, Christy, we're coming to you. Better be there. Hi, Christy. Oh. Hi, Christy.
Hello.
Hello.
Hello. Can you hear me now?
Yes.
Yeah.
Bonus. I have a question.
Yes.
I would like to know if my aunt and myself will mend our bridges in this lifetime, or if the relationship has run its course.
Okay, tell me where the aunt is in your family tree.
She would be my mother's youngest sister.
Thank you. Wow. So the simple answer is no. The complicated answer is you're still on the path and she's not. This happens a lot. Sometimes we don't want How do I say this? sometimes we don't want to change. And so our free will takes us over, and I'm talking about your aunt, not you, takes us over to a place where we sever certain contracts, or we, I like to say, modify them. And that's what she's done. But you're still in a place where you want to fix it.
Yes.
And so what I'm hearing is, it is what it is. Accept her for who she is. And adjust yourself around that. And what that means is, don't just, you know, people go, oh, I just have to accept it. No. Yes, you have to accept them for who they are and how they are. But then you adjust yourself around that. How does now that person being that way, how does that fit in my life? And that's where your free will comes in. Definitely don't keep pushing or energetically pushing, trying to make it work, because it's not going to. It's like she gave up.
Okay.
And something happened to her that made her give up. And really, it has nothing to do with you. It has to do with who she is and whatever's went on in her life to make her kind of give up. And it's not just give up on the relationship with you. She's given up on the relationship with a lot of people. It's just
okay.
you're one of them. And so you have the bigger heart, so you want to make it work. And she's just disconnected. And when we disconnect like that, that's where we modify our contract. And the reason we do that kind of automatically is because we don't want to hurt the other people. And then it's us who gets stuck if we don't realize that it's over. We don't realize that we can't do anything for that person, or that we can't help or fix the relationship.
Well, thank you, Lisa. That's going to save me a lot of energy.
Yes, it does. It does. Unfortunately, I've been in that boat where I kept wanting more from someone in my family. And when I finally looked at the records, it was like he gave up. And the interesting thing for mine is he gave up like 20 years before I even looked. It's just I am that, quote, good person who thinks we should figure this out. We should be connected. We're family after all. So just allow yourself to have whatever you want, whatever relationship you want with her, in the boundaries of who she is.
Okay, I can do that.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you for calling.
Thanks, Christy. She wanted to know, you're welcome, Chris. She wanted to know, I thought she was going to ask, why do I want to be a stamp flicker?
And I would say, what the heck is a stamp licker?
Muted herself and doesn't want to talk to me anymore. But that's okay, Christy. I won't take it personally. Okay. Let's go.
I can't even do that.
Could you answer my question? Is ID Idaho or India? Idaho, right? Is Idaho ID? Who's Idaho? Who is ID in your state? ID.
Idaho, yeah.
Idaho, I'm coming to you.
That's me.
Who's
me?
This is Lorraine.
Hi, Lorraine.
Hi there. Yeah, I'm way over in Idaho.
There you go. Well, we won't hold that against you.
Yeah, I know. I know, I'm pretty secluded here. I guess my question for Lisa is, I'm wondering what my soul's purpose is, if I have a purpose going forward.
That's a bit too general.
That's too general.
That's
okay.
Too general.
Let's see.
Let me ask you, have an inkling of what you're meant to be doing? Do you have an inkling, any idea?
Well, now, the reason why I've been so interested in your radio station stuff, I have been told I have the gift, but I don't know how to use it. And I guess I don't know how to word. Pardon me?
The gift for what?
Like, to be psychic. And I don't know how, and I've just been told this. I don't know if it's true. And I don't know how to word it to ask you.
Well, okay, so first of all, we're all psychic. Just some of us are open, some of us are closed. Second, there are so many things attached to that word psychic.
Okay.
So many different avenues, so many different venues, so many different things. And so if that's something you want to develop, first you have to take a look at yourself and see what interests you.
So is that a kind of question I could ask you?
Mm-hmm.
I would think that if you
okay, I'll ask you that question.
Go ahead, Chris.
Oh, wait a minute.
Oh.
The question I think would be, you know, am I meant to be pursuing, am I meant to be pursuing the study of metaphysics? How about that?
Beautiful.
Well, that's very broad. Metaphysics is huge.
Well, okay.
That's why I asked, is there something that interests you, like giving mediumship or tarot reading or animals? Like, is there something specific that you feel connected to?
Well, probably more the mediumship, I guess.
Okay. So then that's more of with Chris's
question.
Help, we're getting to the question. Like, okay. Is mediumship a path I should follow?
Okay, there you go. I'm sorry. Go ahead.
That's okay. All right, give me just a minute.
Okay.
And it's Lorraine, correct?
Yes.
Okay. Oh, well, that's interesting. So it's taken you a really long time to get to this point in your life, hasn't it?
Yes.
On the scroll, it's like life, 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 life. Oh, wake up.
Wake up.
Oh, I'm supposed to be doing something else because it's been listed. Mediumship is there, but very minor. And the interesting thing, which I haven't seen this in ages, is I saw two things. I saw palmistry and hand analysis. They're both very different. Hand analysis has more to do with your fingerprints, the prints,
okay,
the lines, the things you don't see, where palmistry has to do with the lines. And it's interesting because what I saw was you needed something physical. It's, for some
okay.
reason, attaching to something outside of yourself, because that's what mediumship
okay.
is. Mediumship, you just kind of let go and you trust in the universe and your guides and whatever you're doing to connect
okay.
and bring it through. But you're missing that. You need something physical. Now, for some
okay.
people who want to study mediumship, they start with tarot cards because that's a physical medium.
Okay.
But I keep seeing the hands for you. Like, it's all about the hands. And that could
like,
also have to do with healing. That could be a step into healing as well.
Okay. You mean like reading people's hands? Is that
yes.
what you mean?
Yes.
Okay.
And I know someone who does hand analysis, but I don't have their information.
Okay.
So if you would do me a favor, because I'm not going to
yeah.
remember this, if you would go to my Facebook page,
okay.
Sky Sacred Sanctuary, send me a message that you're Lorraine and
okay.
to give you Mary's information.
Okay.
A friend of mine does hand analysis. She's phenomenal and she teaches.
Huh. Well,
but I know she has things on her website so that you could read. Like, this is the purpose.
Oh.
So that I can give you her website so that you can read about what this is about. Because hand analysis is very different than palmistry. But it's like, I saw both for you. And one was not bigger than the other. So you will probably take both and work with them together.
Okay. Is this something you see in the near future or when I'm 70?
Like now, like you should have already been doing it. Like it's already been a part of your life. And it's kind of like on your scroll, it was like interested. Oh, this is what I'm supposed to be doing. But you just went around it.
Huh.
Like I learned a little of this and I learned a little of that. You can learn mediumship, and I would suggest you learn mediumship because it will help you with your intuitive abilities.
Okay.
It'll help you disconnect from that physical hand to feeling the energy of the hand to knowing, you know, the information.
Okay.
It's like learning tarot cards. Like you learn what all the imagery means. God, tongue tied. And then you use your intuitiveness to discern what that is after the fact.
Well, is it true that, like, tarot cards, that it's better for someone to buy them for you, or can you just buy them and they'd
You can buy them. No, you can buy them.
Okay.
And I highly recommend people go and, like, look at them. Like, there are some stores where you can touch them. You know, they have packs where you can look at them. Yeah. They have, like, open packages. And I always suggest doing that, and that's how I found my first tarot. Well, my first deck was given to me, and then my second deck I found for myself.
Okay.
But I was, you know, 16.
I had just read, I can't remember where, if I Googled it or something, that they said, you know, it's best to have someone give them to you than to go out and buy new. And I just, your opinion is,
honestly, I think
matter.
If you're just starting out, you should pick your own. And they should be cellophane wrapped, you know, no energy of anybody else on them so that you can start working with your own energy so that you can get used to feeling that energy and create your own connection.
Okay.
I don't ever recommend like using other people's cards or.
All right.
Yeah.
Well, it's kind of, when you say to read hands and stuff, I deal one-on-one with people all day long with different people, and it would probably be kind of neat to be involved in something like that, not to read these people, but to kind of get a feel of what I'm looking for.
Yes.
So,
and that could possibly be part of it, because I don't see it as like your main career. You probably could, but it's like this part of you that you need in your life. That's what it looks like on the scroll. When I read scrolls, if it's like, okay, so I read this guy who was meant to come here to be an environmental attorney. Like,
okay.
It was his life. And he was going over here. He's a yoga instructor. He was this. He was that. He's doing all these other things. And I'm like, you're supposed to be a lawyer. My dad's a lawyer. I'm not being a lawyer, you know, like. And I'm like, no, you're supposed to be an environmental lawyer. Well, here we are 10, 15 years later. Yeah, he's an environmental lawyer in California. Yeah.
Well, see, now I don't think I ever would have thought to do hands or anything unless I would have called tonight and asked you, because I would have never, ever thought something like that.
And you probably have been getting little signs, because what happens is when we kind of get a sign to learn something, like you got an inkling that maybe you would want to do mediumship. And once you learned mediumship, through that, you would probably get to where you realize, oh, I don't like giving myself up so much.
Okay.
And then that's where things open for you and say, oh, well, maybe I could try this or maybe I could try that. And you would eventually get to the hands, but your poor chart, it's like, it's like there were signs earlier in your life.
Okay. I know when I was really little, I used to feel someone sitting on my bed all the time. And I think my family, we used to hear things and see things and feel things. And I, I'm sure back then I was intuitive, but I just, as life goes on, you get busy raising kids and work and whatnot.
And you close down.
My kids have grown and moved out. Now it seems like things have slowed down, and I guess that's where I'm thinking about it more.
Mm-hmm.
So, okay. So send you a message.
Yes, please.
And let me know about Mary.
Please. Yes. Mary's website.
Oh,
yes.
Mary's website. Bye. Okay. Well, I appreciate that, Lisa.
You're welcome. And there are lots of books out there. I mean, you can go to the library and get books on palm reading, palmistry.
Okay.
You know, and you can probably Google it and get information.
Does it say I'll be good at it? Does my scroll say I'll be good at it?
It's like part of your life, so you would be good at it.
Okay.
It's like the first time I read my Akashic Records. Uh-huh. I mean, I was never supposed to do anything else. And let me tell you, I took the low road. I went to corporate America. Even though I had this gift, I went through corporate America. I did the whole thing. Six-figure job, you know.
Oh, wow.
And then I got laid off. And, like, literally the same day I got laid off, I started working for a friend doing readings.
Wow.
Working in her shop. I had done psychic fairs for her, but I started working in her shop the next day. And it was like, the universe couldn't have shoved me any harder, you know?
Well, I know there's no one locally around me that does it, you know, that advertises anyway. And so,
right.
So I just call Chris. Okay. Well, thank you for your time.
You're welcome, honey.
Okay. All right.
Okay. Good night.
Bye-bye.
Okay. All right, so now I'm going to go and get, I guess this is Sandy.
Oh, very good, yes. Hello.
Hello.
Hi, Lisa. Hi, Chris.
Hi.
Hello.
I'm having a hard time thinking of one question, but let's see how this sounds. I want to know how well I'm doing as a mother for my child, why he was brought into my life, and what the purpose outcome of this is supposed to be.
Okay, I'm not quite understanding that part of the question. I mean,
being vague. Okay.
You have a child. You have a child, so you have a relationship with. You have a partnership with them. Are you wanting to know kind of the purpose of the partnership?
Yes.
So, like, big picture partnership.
Yeah.
Why you came to be connected.
Right.
At this time.
Right.
Okay. How old is your child?
16.
Is this your only child?
Yes.
Sorry, I say that because I see the possibility of having two children, but you're beyond that point.
Right.
Oh, my. Okay, so I don't want this to sound horrible, so I'm going to say it, and then I'm going to tell you why I'm saying it. You came to give birth to him. He came to live a hard life. He decided he wanted to learn in a hard way, and he hasn't even started.
Oh, God.
And by hard, I don't mean, okay, so when I say hard, I don't mean drug addicts, things like that. I mean just hard decisions. He also came with, okay, I don't know what this means because I'm not reading his chart, I'm reading yours. But he came, I don't even know how to say this, like he's missing. Okay, so you know how some people come to this world and they just don't have common sense, or they don't have aptitude, or they don't, you know, there's certain things we just don't have. He's decided that in this lifetime, he doesn't want so much common sense. It's like he wanted to learn harder. And of course, once you get, you know, to yourself on the other side, it's not that, you know, you're like a better soul because you've learned harder. It's the personality of the being. What do I need to learn harder? And it's like he feels he needs to learn harder, more difficult lessons. But again, I'm not, okay, so it's a flow. Because I'm seeing him kind of, and I'm jumping into like his 20s. Like he's going to leave your life, he's going to come back to your life. But I'm not seeing like traumatic events. I'm not seeing, you know, he's going to become a drug addict and you're going to have to push him away. I'm not seeing anything like that. I'm just seeing this flow. And you, your agreement was to be the woman who gave birth, be that constant in his life.
Really?
Wow. But let him go. Let him go through it.
And why would I have chosen that? Is that, can I ask that question or is that a different question?
Okay, so so now I need to ask what your relationship is beyond this lifetime.
Oh.
As to why you would agree to be together in this lifetime.
Oh.
So give me just a sec. Because he did the same for you.
Oh.
A few lifetimes ago, it wasn't your last, but a few lifetimes ago, he's your father.
So I'm just,
and it was very, your lifetime was very, you were a woman. Your lifetime was very different. It's like you wanted to be a strong woman in a time when women were not strong, meaning you wanted to be the Madame Curie. You wanted to be, the Amelia Earhart. Like that was your path. I get you were more scholastic. So you're probably a professor or author, which I'm getting was not common in that time. And like he supported that. He was the father who allowed you to do that, but let you fall. Like I'm seeing your last, that lifetime, and it's like you fell a lot. You got a lot of doors slammed in your face. You got addicted to something and had to work through that. And now we're doing, now he's having his turn. But again, you have to kind of step back and look at it. Couple of hundred years ago, you had that life, the world was different. And he's come to do the same, similar thing in the world that we live in, which is very different. The lessons are still the same. The emotions are still the same. The objective is still the same. It's just a different, like being on a different planet.
So it sounds like my role is just to support him.
You're to be his constant. That's like in big letters. You're to be his constant. It's like he needs to know that even if he screws up, you'll still love him.
Okay.
Even if he chooses the most horrible path, you will still love him. And this is a horrible example, but, you know, serial killers had mothers.
Right.
And they were typically the constant. Not that your son's a serial killer. He's never going to go that far. No, that's not even close. Okay. Not even close. It's just, that's just, you know, a magnified idea.
Okay.
It's like that. It's like everybody has to have someone or something in their life. And that's he will flow in and he will flow out. He's just going to make tough decisions and he will get married. He will have a steady job. You know, I'm not seeing dysfunctional.
Really?
I'm not seeing horribly dysfunctional. And I'm at 22 right now where he kind of shifts himself into a better place. He probably won't go to college. I'm seeing more technical, whatever he does, but he'll be good at it.
Okay, that was my next question.
It'll take him a while to figure out what that is.
For Ted, one question. So we have 9 minutes left. So.
Okay. but the point is, you're just supposed to, he needs to know you're there for him. If I screw up, I need to know my mom, you know, isn't going to say, you dumb piece of shit. She's going to say, well, what did you learn?
Okay.
Like that.
Yeah.
That's the constant.
He's been a tough one the whole time. So I'm like, why did I sign up for this?
Because you did the same.
Right. Okay. Well, I appreciate it. Thank you so much.
You're welcome.
Thanks, Chris.
Yeah, good luck.
All right. 8 minutes of counting.
Okay. Now, Mary Margaret, I was trying to get your attention, so you have 3 seconds to answer me. Are you listening or are you here for a reading?
Oh, Mary Margaret.
Just listening, okay? I'm going to try this anonymous person one more time. Who's this?
Oh, I'm glad you came back to me and I woke up.
You got to make it quick because we're running low on time. So you need to have a specific question.
Who is this?
I got it.
How about a name?
It's Queen. I've been listening in and out. I got the vibe, and the question is, in the creative, my creative powers, which are unlimited, in which areas should I be focusing on utilizing to make them grow in the most magnificent
way? Okay, you need to be
possible.
A little more specific. Is there a certain area you want to know as part of your path?
The arts.
That's incredibly broad. What part of the arts? Is there something in the arts?
I deal with a lot of the arts.
So let me ask.
But is there something? Do you like to paint? Do you like to sculpt? Do you like to draw? Do you?
I have a better, I think I can get at this.
Go ahead.
So you do many different artistic things, Queen. Is there a particular area that you're thinking you'd like to venture into, but you're not sure if that would be prosperous or successful for you? Is there a particular artistic venture you're hemming and hawing about that you would like some guidance on?
Not him and Haran, but let's go with dance performance.
Okay. Okay. And I'm sorry, your first name again?
Queen.
Okay, I'm sorry. The first thing I get is, yes, you could do great in dance. You could do great in whatever it is you wanted to do. You just have to decide what you want to do. Your chart doesn't have anything specific. It's not that you came to dance. It's not that you came to draw. It's not that you came to paint. It's that you came to be a part of the industry. So whether you are the artist or the person taking care of the artist or the painter or whatever. But I'm hearing the big thing you came to learn is to choose one. And it can be one at a time. You know, it can be I start with dance and maybe I get a couple of years in with this and I decide, okay, I've done everything I can here. What's next? You can do it that way. But yeah, your record is definite. It's definite list. It's listing individually. It's not conglomerate like creative arts, like I'm doing all in the creative arts. It's listing separate things. And I'm literally seeing drawing, kind of like charcoal drawing, painting, sculpting. Dance is kind of at the bottom. Is there such a thing as performance art?
Sure there is.
Okay, so that's in there too. Sorry, this isn't my field. I don't know all those. But it's kind of like, it's like you've come to develop all of them inside of yourself. But again, the chart is specific individually. So it's like, how can I explain this? It's like, this is a weird explanation, but it's like going up the corporate ladder. I have to hit each rung and learn whatever I need to do before I can get to the next rung. So you pick an area in your creative arts that appeals to you at the moment, and you place yourself in that. You know, you take classes, you learn, you maybe even teach, and you get to, and then you'll, it's just kind of the flow of life. And then after many years, you'll get to like another ridge and you'll go, oh, I want to learn more about this now. Like you just came to experience all of it. But what they're making me feel is like you're trying to cram too much in at the same time. And then that causes a disconnect. So just choose one thing at a time. And whatever it is, just know you'll be good at it. You'll enjoy it. But you have to experience it for a certain length of time before you can go on to the next.
Okay.
And it's interesting. It has to do with friendships too. Like in each phase, you will gain more friendships, important friendships. And they just closed the book. I always like when they do that. It's like, that's enough.
Interesting. Thank you. I will walk with that. And, you know, you said something, because I listened last week, and I, like I said, I've been listening in and out. Mm-hmm. But it was something about reading the record for yourself.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what's resonating with me now, that I need to go in there myself.
Mm-hmm. Yes. And that's the meditation we did, and you can get that meditation on my website too. You can download it.
Yes. And tonight I was able to hear it better than the other night. It was going in and out. So I thank you for that, because it just triggered for me, you know, just go in there yourself.
Mm-hmm.
Because I heard what you said, but I also know me. And I'm going to say that for me, just as we are all connected, and even though you said take one, the one is all, from my perspective, the source of life, the one is all. And the creative aspect for me is a collective, because for me to dance, I go into designing clothing, going against everything you said, mm-hmm. you know, to clothing, and then bringing in my artistic musician friends, and maybe coming up with some poetry and having a painter paint the scenes, so for me it's a collaboration of the many faces of the art and for the art with you. But I thank you because you just made me go into it myself and trust my.
Well, I mean, it's not exactly that. You're doing all of it. There isn't a specific thing, and that's exactly what you're doing. And it sounds to me more like you need to be like the producer. Like you can also be a contributor, but being the producer or director of it all, and contributing some of it too. Like you wouldn't be the first director that starred in their own film type of thing, right? And so, but you still need all the other actors. And the thing is this, is that when you go in on your own, you have hours that you can poke around and lead to the next right. thing and the next, you know, we had, you know, 6 minutes to do this in. So that's how come Lisa needs to have, you know, some idea of what you're wanting to focus on. So, good luck with that, Queen. Getting into the journey on your own there.
Okay. Thank you. Because that's what you really triggered in me. And I thank you for the offering of the Akashic Records, the remembering that, they're there to be looked into.
Yes. Different. And, yeah. you know, in your instance, I would go in and choose one area or whatever's in front of you right now. So if you're doing a project right now, go into the Akashic Records and say, what is the importance of this now for me? What am I to learn from it? What am I to give from it?
I shall enter just that way. Thank you.
Okay. Good luck. Thank you for calling.
Oh, it was my pleasure. I'm glad I woke up right in time, too.
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Thank you very much. And go back to sleep. And okay, so we got background to everybody but Eric, and that's fine. Seen Eric typing in the chat room either. He might have gotten busy with something else. So skysilverhawk.com. And I don't know why that crazy extra thing came there when I went to paste your message bubble when I went to paste your link. So I'm going to have to fix that. But here, we'll put it in there properly for you guys into the chat room. There you go. Okay. So thanks, Lisa. That was awesome.
Thanks. Thanks for having me.
Oh, thank you for being had.
And I'll be back in 4 weeks.
4 weeks, yeah. You are, I'm sure I have you in, right? Let me just go move forward. Yeah. Yeah, exactly. You're going to be the last Monday of every month, right?
Correct.
Yeah, last Monday of every month.
Last Monday of every month or fourth Monday? I could do last because this isn't the last. Is it the last? Oh, it is the last.
Yeah. Like, I think that's the distinction I had to make is.
I'll do the last. That's fine. It's
no,
just.
I'm pretty sure you are on the last. I haven't yet found a case not the last.
Okay.
The last and the fourth is definitely different.
Right.
And I think that is. I'm pretty sure it's last, Lisa. But anyway, my calendar is there, and you know what I mean? It's there, it's up to date, and if you're in doubt, either email me or just go to curioustimes.ca and check it out.
Okay.
And nobody ever goes to my website anyway, so may as well be some reason. You know what I mean? Like, I have the freaking thing. I don't even know why I have the stupid thing, but I have the stupid thing, and it is what it is. But it has the fancy schmancy calendar. I do, despite the awful background. That's rude.
That's not nice.
No, despite the awful background. Oh my god. I'm going to delete, and forgive. I forgive Deb for that public insult that she just did on me. Anyway, Lisa, so we'll talk to you soon, and we'll figure out between now and what our topic will be next time, okay?
Okay.
Thanks, Lisa. Take it easy.
Good night.
Oh, by the way, isn't it funny, after all that, like, you didn't break up anymore after that. You know what I mean?
Really? Isn't that interesting?
All the freaking, you know, anyway, it is typical. So anyway, we'll see you next time. Have a great sleep when you get there.
All right. Thanks.
Thanks, Lisa. Hey, guys. So are we doing overtime or are we not doing overtime? You guys tell me. I'm going to throw in a song and you guys tell me in the chat room whether we're doing overtime or not doing overtime, because I'm happy either way. And let me just scroll real, and what are we going to do? Oh, I haven't heard this song in a long time. Here. something that, like, last night in the show, it was about 50 minutes into the show, but I started a little bit late. Was that Sunday night? What did I have? I just opened the wrong show is what I did because I didn't refresh my page. So hang on, let me find it. Please stand by. I might run and I got all into that song. I haven't heard that song in a long time. Oh, yeah, Kelly. Okay, here, I'm going to open that show up. I got a couple of minutes. It didn't start recording like right at 8, so it would be within 3 minutes or 5 minutes or something, I think. And so I'm going to just quick, if I can find it real quick, then I will.
Church pew in Elizabeth. So I don't know if that, like, that's just what I interpreted as. So it could be Ellie or Elizabeth. So I'm going to ask that if you say yes, no, or I don't know, because that way I want to be able to validate. If it is your mom, I want to be able to validate it for you. So let me just see what else I can get from her, okay? And just see.
Could it be L-O-I-E? Loie?
I mean, it could be. I'm not quite sure. I just was seeing kind of like, I don't know. I'm seeing like E-L-I-E, but it could, you know, like I said, names are not my thing. So, like, if I get a name, I'm like, whoa, that's okay. I feel better. But oftentimes names are not my thing. So I just put it out there. If I get it, and I kind of just, I throw it out there. If it applies, then fantastic. If it doesn't, I don't really give it much of my attention because it's not really the bulk of what I do. So, okay. So let me just see what else I get. And then if you could just answer like yes, no, or I don't know, that would be so great just so that I can know that I'm validating you. So let me just try to get this energy to be closer so I can get a little bit more on it, okay?
Okay, thank you.
Okay, so I got pound cake. I don't know what pound cake is, what pound cake means. But I got pound cake.
Actually, what I'm going to do is, okay, I'm at 5226 there. Because I think someone said something in the chat room, so I can just scroll forward and
okay.
find
Okay, so that's what I'm dealing with him?
In the chat room. I think someone said something in the chat room, didn't they? Heath, did you say something? Let me go back to my current chat. Sherry and Heath. Yeah, so one of you guys said something. So, okay, so now I'm gonna, it has to have been there. Oh, I know what it was. Maybe it was before, okay, right. It would be before the 50-minute mark on the, I can't get rid of this. Okay, there, now. It would, okay, there we go. EVP, woman talking. Okay, let me back this up. And then curly, and that could be curly hair.
Okay. A church pew of some sort. But then she comes at me like, damn, here I am. So she's got a lot of beach sand, so, okay.
Even right.
I'm sorry.
It could be even green glass. Green
yeah.
glass.
Mm-hmm.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. It's almost like a seafoam green color is what I'm seeing. So, okay. So let me just try to get someone closer. You know, rather than just symbols. So, an older woman who.
Now it's going to be
okay. So I'm hearing, I'm feeling a female energy. It's an older woman, and she's got white hair,
and she, I feel like she's little, but I heard, bam, here I am. So it's one of those, she's got a lot of energy. I'm seeing like an older woman who looks almost like you would expect her to be, kind of straight or boring, but she's actually got a lot of energy to her. So I don't know if that means anything to anybody. I'm just kind of getting symbols at first.
So a green gemstone in sand, is that what you said?
Well, it's almost like a green.
Oh, I get you.
Mm-hmm. It's almost like a sea foam green color is what I'm seeing.
It doesn't.
Okay, so I'm feeling a female energy. It's an older woman, and she's got white hair, and I feel like she's little, but I heard, bam, here I am. So it's one of those, she's got a lot of energy. I'm seeing like an older woman who looks almost like you would expect her to be, kind of straight or boring, but she's actually got a lot of energy to her.
4230.
I'm sorry?
Nothing.
Wow.
Hang on.
Oh, I heard something.
I didn't hear it. You see, I did not hear it on the show. Everyone else heard it, but I did not hear it. 42.
Boring, but she's actually got a lot of energy to her. I'm sorry?
Shit. Of course I dropped my stupid thing right at the time. A, you hate dropping your expensive e-cigarette. And it happened right during so the spirit world just made me drop that. You know what I mean?
Over sand, over beach sand. So, okay.
That's even, right?
I'm sorry?
It could.
One of those, she's got a lot of energy. I'm seeing like an older woman who looks almost like you would expect her to be, kind of straight or boring, but she's actually, a lot of energy to her.
It was almost just like I think it was a echo, just for that one little bit. Yeah, it was an echo to what she said. Yeah, I'll play it again, but I'm pretty sure that that's what that was. Hang on.
I'm feeling a female energy. It's an older woman, and she's got white hair, and I feel like she's little, but I heard, bam, here I am. So it's one of those, she's got a lot of energy. I'm seeing like an older woman who looks almost like you would expect her to be, kind of straight or boring, but she's actually got a lot of energy to her.
Yeah, it's an echo. I might not have heard it because it might have been caused by my line somehow. But good catch, you guys. Good catch. Good catch. Okay, let's see. Everybody who's there, unmute yourselves, okay, if you want. Unmute yourselves. And then as soon as you guys get on here, I can skip to the loo real quick before my eyeballs float away. I'm going to thank. Hello. Thank you, archive listeners. We're back. We're maybe back tomorrow. I don't know if I'm going to do something tomorrow. Nick can't make it, so he's rescheduled to the following Monday. So if I can figure out what to do, we'll be here. Or we could just do a silly ash music show, or I don't know, whatever. So thank you, archive listeners. Peace out. Have a great night.